Well, hello and welcome to Kemper Bushcraft. And welcome to my series Bushcraft from A to Z. And today it's letter Y, and I decided it should be about you. Why are you practicing bushcraft?
Why are you interested in bushcraft? Perhaps you just like to watch YouTube videos and be relaxed that way. Or you live in a big city and can't go out into nature. Perhaps you have some health issues restrict you in your activity. Maybe you are a weekend bushcrafter and practice your hobby in a simple and very easy way. Or maybe you want to test yourself by staying outdoor even under the hardest conditions. We are all different, and our approach to bushcraft depends on many factors. How experienced are you? Are you in the learning phase, or do you master most of the bushcraft skills and just want to practice and improve your skills? Are you old, young, or just a child? These things matter a lot and can affect the way you are practicing bushcraft. Do you have enough money so you can buy the best gear you can find and travel to far places where you can practice your bushcraft hobby? Perhaps you're on the budget and have to buy cheap gear in discount stores. Or like me, love to make your own gear or customize your gear so it fits your personal taste. The geographic factor can also affect the way you are looking at bushcraft. If you're like me, living in the northern part of the world, in Canada, Scandinavia or Siberia, you may have been affected by the local culture that have deep roots in the native wilderness living. Perhaps you have learned some important crafting skills from your grandfather. Maybe you had to learn it the hard way by all the mistakes we all make. If you're living in a warmer climate, perhaps you have other materials to work with and thereby practicing your bushcraft in a different way than we do here in the northern hemisphere. Your cultural or religious background can also play a significant role in the way you're looking at bushcraft. Some religions forbid you to eat pork, so you can't eat those nice bacon slices I just made over the fire. Or perhaps you can't move as freely as I can. No matter what, bushcraft is a wonderful and rewarding hobby that you can practice in a thousand ways. And remember, there's no wrong or right way to do it. Just do it.
Well, this is all for now, folks. I hope you enjoy my little series Bushcraft from A to Z. But before I go, I would like to show you a couple of things. Some of my subscribers have sent me some stuff I would like to show you. Yesterday, I received a package from a subscriber in Great Britain called Daryl from Sussex. And he sent me some stuff, some beef jerky and fatwoods and so on. And this little pouch that I can have wear on my belts. It's a very old school looking pouch with an awesome mechanism here, and in here I have my I have my little tin where I keep my resin in. So thank you, Daryl, for this. I'll have it on my belt from now on. From a subscriber in Germany, Peter, I received this old tinderbox out of brass, and it's really cool, and I will have it in my rucksack with some tinder. And thank you very much, Peter, for this. I appreciate it very much. It's old school and I like it. And I would like to make a shout out for a channel from Russia. A young guy called Alex is making some very nice and interesting videos out there. He doesn't talk a lot in his videos, so you can easily understand what's going on. I think you should check his channel out, and of course I put a link below. And his Instagram name is Urban Survival. His YouTube channel is in Russian writing, so I don't know what it's called. Perhaps it's the same. I don't know, Alex, but I certainly think you should check him out and give him your support. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe to his channel. Well, this is all for now, folks. Thank you for watching Kemper Bushcraft. I hope you like this video, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye. Take care.